community organizations throughout the Bay Area, including Rise Up Yolo County, including Anapayan, and various other community organizations. But more specifically, I'm from Lady College. I'm a current community college student. I actually missed college today to come to this right in the heart of Oakland and Chinatown. So speaking as a Filipino student, it is important to me that Filipino studies is included within the framework of Asian American studies. I had grown up with the K-12 educational system where all I got to learn about Filipinos and my people is that tiny little paragraph where we're talking about Americans liberating us from the Spanish and again liberating us from the Japanese. I never got to learn about the Filipino monarchs in the UFW. I never knew that 6,000 of my fellow Filipinos leave the Philippines every single day to work as disposable labor throughout the world. And due to one-sided economic agreements that perpetuate poverty in my homeland. As a Filipino-American student, I want to see culturally relevant education, not just in the college level, but also high school as well. Culturally relevant education will also support our Asian and Pacific Islander community at Laney College, whom experience disproportionately high dropout rates and low retention. Yet students are often discouraged to take these classes due to the misconception that these classes are prereqs to majors that won't put food on the table. But we should change that. We want this education to be available to all, especially given the benefits that it will produce. And real quick, something that I wanted to highlight, at Laney College, I think the person before me couldn't make it, so I'm kind of asking for extra time, if that's okay. At Laney College, we're also under the threat of the Oakland A Stadium, which is proposed to be built right across the street, which will cause hundreds of working class Asian American immigrant families to be impacted by heightened gentrification. The root of this issue is that our community colleges are underfunded, and our public education is increasingly privatized to the point where the Peralta district sees the stadium as an opportunity to make more money. Yet, we are supposed to be sanctuary campuses, right? Yet, this decision will further displace and militarize these communities of color, particularly significant undocumented populations within our community. The fight doesn't just end with culturally relevant education. But to take a stand against the privatization of education and to commit standing against the militarization of our communities. Thank you.
I do want to mention that we are now joined by the chair of the API Legislative Caucus, who also is the first Filipino American to be elected in the state legislature. Okay, thank you.
My name is Michelle.